Hi, Jules Cruise Companion. What people have been asking over the last couple of weeks after I came out of the Middle East was how I tie some of my headscarves. So what I'd like to show you today is three examples of how to tie the same scarf. So if you have three or four different scarves and you learn to tie each scarf three different ways, you can end up with a repertoire of between 9 and 12 different looks. So what I'd like to show you is just the basic scarf that I'm using. So this is just a viscose scarf that someone has given me, a beautiful gift. And what I've done is I've folded it in over itself. The next thing I'm going to do is find the halfway point. The reason this one works so well, it's so soft. Once you've found the halfway point, what we're going to do is we're just going to throw it over. One of my tips is I actually tie really quite low over my eyebrows, and that way, and once I've done my tie, once I've done my scarf, I can move it to wherever I want. So what you're going to do in the first instance is you're just going to make sure that each of the ends are kind of in a nice pigtail, and you're just going to pass each pigtail over itself. And what we're going to do with this one, we can either do it two ways. We can just do it as a straight without doing a twist or anything of that nature, just to make it a bit of a larger band. And then when you finally, when you get to the edge, just tuck it in. And you can do the same for the other side. And then you can just reposition over the eyebrows where you feel comfortable. So there's one look, which is almost like a full turban. So the second scarf is going to be almost exactly the same, but when we actually do the pigtails over the back, we'll actually do a bit of a twist. So once again, make sure that the scarf is folded in half, then find the natural halfway point. Keeping it low, as I say, that's just my preference. Bringing it open. And then what we can do is just do a light twist. We don't want to bunch it too small because it makes the actual twist look too small across your head. Swing it across. And we tuck it in. What we're going to do, don't worry about that little bit section there, we'll try and tidy that up in a second. Swing it over the other side. So you can see with this one, if it was a multi coloured scarf, you could have some different color text and textures. But there we have a scarf with a twist. So the last scarf I'm going to look at using this, the last look that I'm going to use using this particular scarf is going to be, once again, keeping it folded over, but this time coming to the end as far as possible. So when we do anchor it on our head and making our two pigtails. One of the pigtails at the back is actually really quite short. So what you're going to do is you're actually going to take the longest of the two pigtails. What I've actually seen is this one where they tie this at the back, but that just makes it too bunchy for me. So I just really pull the longer pigtail over as tightly as I can, and it just anchors it to my head. Then what I'm going to do is just do a light twist, choosing which way you want your twist to go. actually come back on yourself the first time. Find where your twist started and just bring your pigtail through. And what I choose to do is I choose to tidy the other shorter section by just poking it up to the back. And at this time I can just move the scarf to wherever I like on my head if I just want to show a little bit of eyebrows. So there we have with a turban with a tail. So what I'd like to show you is actually one of those ties, the ones with the twist, but just with a different scarf. This scarf has two different colours. Once again, I folded it over to its natural halfway point. And I'm going to find halfway again. Flip, get the pigtails. Do a nice light twist. So that looks to have a fair bit of purple on it. So when I do the other one, I'm just going to have to make sure that the brown is to the outside. As much as I would like, but anyway, you get the principle. So that way you have a bit of colour and depth to the scarf as well. Same technique, different scarf, different look. So this is Jules Cuckoo's Companion. Saying that's a couple of nice interesting looks that you can use when you are either traveling or when you are just at home and wanting to do something just that little bit different. Hope you enjoy. Happy travels.